Hey everyone, welcome to episode 4 of our viewer Q&A, where we answer questions from viewers like you. Our first question comes from Kathy Vanderbilt. Kathy asks, since you often camp in bear country, have you ever had any close encounters at your campsite, and what precautions do you take for safety?
In the 7 years I've been on the road, I've never had a close encounter with a bear, or really any wildlife for that matter, at my campsite. I'll admit, I was a little careless when I lived alone in my truck and never followed any of the bear precautions that you hear about. I'd cook all of my meals on my tailgate with bacon grease splattering everywhere. I'd store my leftovers in an open cast iron skillet underneath my sleeping platform, and I'd have a cooler in my sleeping area in plain sight. All that being said, I still never once had an issue with bears or any other wildlife trying to get into my truck. Now, we take a little more precaution. Obviously, we always keep our campsite clean and never leave trash or recycling outside. When we leave the campsite, we make sure that all of the food inside the camper is stored out of sight and also close the blinds so that a bear or any other wildlife can't see inside. And we also put a blanket over the cooler that we keep in the backseat of our truck to keep it out of sight of wildlife. Still, to this day, we've never had any bear or wildlife issues at our campsite. Our next question comes from Yvonne Louise Marie Lausch. She asked, what editing program are you using for your photography?
That's a great question, Yvonne. My first step is to transfer my images from my memory card to my hard drive in organized, labeled folders. That is really important. Then I import my images into Adobe Lightroom. Here is where I make all of my initial basic adjustments to my image. This is also where I sort my images, stitch together any panoramics I may have shot, and group together my bracketed images. Next, I open any images that need editing beyond what Lightroom can do into Adobe Photoshop. Honestly, any of my final gallery images that you might see online have probably been edited in Photoshop. Some people have complained that Adobe has moved to a subscription-based service, but honestly, you can get Photoshop and Lightroom for $10 a month, and to me, that's an amazing deal. There are also a few third-party plugins that I like to use, my favorite being the Nix Software Collection made by DxO. And although I don't use them, Topaz Labs, On1 Software, and Aurora HDR have become really popular and are also great plugins.
And our third question comes from Lucy Thompson. What are some of the additional items that you need when purchasing a camper that you might not think about?
This is a great question, and honestly, one that I think that people who deal with this every day could answer better than us. Luckily, our friends over at Princess Craft RV in Austin, Texas, have offered to answer an RV-related question with each new Q&A episode. So let's head on over to them for the answer to this question.
Thanks, Mandy, for that question. Cody and I are going to go through just a couple of the things that we see that customers really like to pick up when they get their trailer here at Princess Craft. First is this zip breakaway cable. This will replace your breakaway cable that came with your trailer. It keeps it up off the ground. You don't have to fish it through the chains, and it just makes for a really easy hookup and disconnect, which we all like.
The next product that most of our customers tend to like is going to be our chain up. This keeps our safety chains up off the ground, super easy product to install, and keeps you state legal for no chains dragging on the ground.
It's good to be legal. What is this, Cody?
This is going to be our torque wrench. A lot of people don't think about our torque wrench, but making sure our lug nuts on our wheels is super important, making sure that we don't have any lug nuts or wheels fall off during our vacation.
And last, but certainly not least,
is our lock set, anti-theft. Super easy kit here from Master Lock. Comes with three different locks for your trailer and all key to like, super easy product to keep your trailer secure.
So three locks, one key.
That's right.
Super easy, which we're all about here at Princess Craft. So thanks, Mandy, and we'll see you next time.
See ya.
All of this information and more can be found by going to our website at www.mandyleephoto.com. If you have a question you'd like us to answer, feel free to subscribe to our YouTube channel and comment below. You can also find us on Facebook and Instagram at Mandy Lee Photo. So, Here's to more questions from viewers like you. Love and light.
God, why do I always have to pronounce the hard names?